thank you, Mike. See you later. You drive.
Okay.
Hi.
Hey.
So, I'm sitting at my computer doing all that data entry shit they always stick me with, and I go blind.
You went blind?
Yeah, right there. I couldn't see a thing. So I started yelling, oh my God, I can't see.
Oh my God.
So Susan walks me the lot, and she goes, I get stuck with all the responsibility. And I'm like, you're right, that is so true, you know? It's just you here to help me out, and that's a lot of responsibility to have.
To help like a total blind person?
It is. So she took me by the hand, and she goes, Deb, it's me and you in this together.
Oh, Deb.
I cried all the way to the emergency room.
Oh my God.
So we get there, and the nurse took me right in.
Wow.
Well, she could see it was a serious thing.
Oh, I know.
So I'm sitting there waiting for the doctor on one of those, like, table bed things, you know, whatever they are. Just sitting and waiting all alone. And my sight came back.
Thank God.
It was blurry at first.
Yeah. Oh, my God, Zeb. Thank God.
I know.
Can you see now?
Yeah. I don't know what I'd do if it ever happened again. It was really scary, Beth.
Yeah, it sounds scary.
And the worst part is, the doctor walked in and all, and he goes, it's hysterical blindness.
Oh my God.
And Beth, it's caused by stress.
I told you. I told you, Deb, a long time ago. You gotta learn how to relax.
I know.
But I mean, it's like there's always something bothering you.
Excuse me, things just don't bother me, okay? Things happen to me.
Okay.
Do I look okay?
Do I?
You look really hot.
You too.
Thanks.
What are we gonna order?
Okay, let's start with a shot and then get two rolling rocks.
Yeah, tequila?
Yeah. Salt?
Yes, salt. I don't want people thinking I don't know how to do a shot of tequila.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Carolyn. Hey, congratulations.
Thank you. That is so nice of you to say.
Oh, Deb.
Your mom is so sweet. The girls from my firm, they took me out to Skyways to celebrate my engagement, and your mom waited on us, and we totally had her running around like crazy. She's really sweet.
Yeah? That's nice.
Well, we should go.
Good luck tonight, girls.
Come on, we better hurry, Kat. The guys are waiting for us.
Why did you have to congratulate her?
I don't know. She's a human being, isn't she?
She's wearing pink shoes.
Zeb, will you carry my hairspray?
Beth, when are you gonna get the travel size?
I need the jumbo, okay? I have a lot of hair.
Good, good.
Are you ready?
Don't rush me. All right.
Oh yeah, heaven does fail.
Fuck off.
Bobby's bartending.
Yeah, so?
So it's good to have a bartender we know here.
Yeah.
I would know that best though. After all, I know him better.
Yeah, I remember. Bobby. Hi, Bobby.
Hey, Bob.
Ladies.
We'll have she's gonna have a shot of tequila and a rolling lac, and I'll have something sweet, like a sex on the beach.
You got it.
I changed my mind. I felt like a sex on the beach. Arrest me.
Well, maybe you should tell him I'll have a sex on the beach too.
All right. It's too late.
Great.
Thanks. Sorry.
We had a plan. What are you looking at?
God,
way to stare at him.
I'm not staring, I'm glancing. He's got Patrick Swayze eyes.
He looks mean.
I would drop my pants for him in a second. Hey, baby, you want to slip on some slime?
He's gonna hear you.
So maybe I want him to.
You're never gonna get a guy like that, you know?
Oh my God, Deb, he's coming over here.
No, he's not.
Oh, shit.
See? I told you. He's a conceited jerk.
Hey, Bob.
Yeah?
You know that guy over there?
He looks like trouble.
Never seen him before. Why?
No reason.
Beth was just gonna try and talk to him or something.
Oh, yeah? Think he's cute, Beth?
Yeah, a little.
Ah, so that's your type.
Maybe, maybe not.
Well, what is your type then? Describe him.
Okay. I like a guy who's built and really sure of himself.
I wish I knew someone like that. I'd fix you guys up.
Oh, you would?
A guy like you.
Excuse me.
You gotta be real grateful.
Deb! Debbie! Will you watch our scenes?
Sure.
Deb, wait!
I am so sick of this.
Sick of what?
Sick of my best friend talking to guys and just ignoring me like I'm not even there.
Nobody was ignoring you, Deb.
Yeah, you both were. I mean, we didn't come out tonight just so you could talk to the bartender.
I'm just trying to have a good time, okay? I thought you liked Bobby.
Yeah, he's an asshole, okay? And I don't think you should go to a place like Ollie's with me and act like this.
Act like what? How am I acting?
Like I'm not your best friend. I mean, you wouldn't even be going out if it wasn't for me. You'd still be sitting home with your kid.
I'm just trying to be everybody's friend, Deb, and I don't see anything wrong with that.
You are really belittling yourself.
Belittling? Big word, Deb.
You are. I mean, you throw yourself at every guy you see.
Oh, my God. You should talk. You've been with half the guys in there.
I want to go home.
Now?
Yeah.
No, I don't want to go home now.
You always got to go home early because of your kid. And I always
I'm not finished talking to Bobby.
Oh, my God.
I mean, Beth.
Beth! Oh, my God. Oh, hey. Hey. You got Patrick Swayze eyes, you know?
I do?
Yeah.
That's good, I guess.
Some might say so.
Why'd you lose your hairspray?
No.
Well, what are you doing standing here?
Nothing. No, I came out here because my girlfriend's being a bitch. She's talking to some guy who's been so rude to me.
What, did he say something to you?
No. No, he was just ignoring me, you know, just really, really rude.
Yeah, yeah, sounds it. That's a shame.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm heading out.
Yeah, me too. I'm parked over there. It's my special spot.
What, you want me to walk you to your car?
Yeah, sure. That's mine. Camaro, 84. I'm really into cars.
It's nice.
What's your name?
Rick.
I'm Debbie. I'm in customer service. What do you do?
Oh, I work construction.
Where do you usually hang out?
Well, at home. I got my own house.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You know, once in a while I go and watch some of my buddies play softball.
You don't play?
Nah, I don't got team spirit. I'm always waiting for one of my buddies to do something stupid, though, so I can laugh. I'll root for a good laugh any day.
Me too. I'm exactly like that.
Yeah, well, I gotta get going. See you.
Yeah, see ya. Hey, thanks for walking me to my car. I owe you a drink now.
Yeah, okay. See ya.
All right. I'll be here tomorrow night.
Okay.
Cool.
Hey, cheer up.
Sure. Thanks.
I had a nice time.
Say that again. I did too. You're an early riser. I like you already.
This is my daughter, Debbie. You're up early, honey.
How do you do? My name is Nick Piccolo. I met your mother at the Skyways. I have breakfast there almost every morning.
Is that your Ford in the driveway?
Why, is it parked out of whack?
It's parked in my driveway, that's all.
There's plenty of room for both of the cars, Debbie.
No, there's not, but you wouldn't know that, would you, Ma? You don't drive, remember?
Why are you up so early, Debbie? Something wrong?
I was going to tell you about my night last night. But I guess I won't.
Nice girl.
She can be. Really. All the neighbors used to say that. Want some coffee?
Yeah. A little.
What do you want?
I want to go to Skyway for a Sky High.
Go get your mother.
Let's not be mad. I had to walk all the way home by myself carrying my hairspray. I was standing outside Ollie's last night smoking a cigarette, and Patrick Swayze Eyes walked right up to me and started talking. He talked to you? He must have seen me in the bar or something. We had the most amazing conversation. It was really short, but it was really special.
You said he was a conceited jerk.
I didn't know him then. I do now.
Did you go home with him?
No, it wasn't like that. I just let him walk me to my car.
He walked you to your car?
Uh-huh, he did. This guy is real different. At the end, when we were saying goodbye, he went, cheer up.
Why?
Because he was trying to say something nice to me.
Well, congratulations, Dub.
Amber, can you sit back down? I can't see. What a night. It's amazing how fast everything can change.
And a small orange juice.
You bet. Two eggs, sunny side up. Not runny, but I want them soft.
Oh.
Four extra pieces of toast with the butter put on, all included toast, while it's still hot so it melts evenly. A side of link sausage and a side of hash browns. That must be brown. Can you bring us another ketchup, please, so we don't all have to share the same bottle? And one jumbo-sized Coke.
Coming right up, ladies. Thank you, Mrs. Miller.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Have fun, girls. Is there something going on between you and your mother?
I don't want to talk about my mother, Beth.
Fine.
Your boyfriend's here. I try to give him a table and he goes, no. I prefer to wait till one opens up in Virginia Station.
He just likes my station, that's all.
I hope you don't think something's going to come of this.
Actually, he took me out Friday night and Saturday night. I think maybe he likes my company.
Oh, dear, I hope you didn't sleep with him, Virginia.
Hey.
I've seen this before. I know how this turns out every time.
Go.
Thank you, Mrs. Miller.
Enjoy.
Thanks.
Guess what?
What?
Debbie's mother has a boyfriend.
Oh, my God. Who?
Nobody.
Him.
He's a real asshole.
Is that why you're acting mad at your mother?
I just don't want to watch her get hurt, that's all.
Dab, maybe she's not gonna get hurt.
He's a jerk. Just look at him. See?
Yeah, I guess. Dab, it's okay, you know. Look at it this way. Now you and your mother both met somebody. That could be good.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Hey, Ma. Are you really going out with this guy?
Maybe.
After all these years, you suddenly decide you want to go out with some guy.
Damn it, Debbie, I'm working here.
Can I tell you something here, Ma? You gotta be careful.
People are waiting for the Sky Highs.
Well, after this guy leaves,
I might not stick around this time. I'm not 13 anymore.
There you go. Get you anything else? Mm-mm.
Everybody's looking at you.
No, they're not. Yeah,
they think you look stupid.
No, they don't.
Oh, my God. He's here.
He saw you.
Yeah?
He looked right at you, Dad. I don't think he recognized you.
Yeah, I highly doubt that, Beth. I told him I'd be here tonight, and I'm sure he's gonna come right over.
Yeah, you're right. As soon as he's ready.
I know. All right, I'm gonna go play the jukebox.
Good idea.
What should I play?
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does.
Okay, play anything by Zeppelin. You can't go wrong.
All right. Is he looking?
No.
All right. Here I go.
The bar forever.
Okay.
Let's just go back. Deb, maybe he's not in the mood to talk. Maybe you should just look for another guy tonight.
I can't do that. My mother says guys don't always know how to act, you know, around a girl they really like. She says you have to let guys know how you feel, so then they know how to act around you, you know? You know, she thinks that may be my problem. I'm aloof.
Aloof?
Yeah. All right. I'm going over there. Right? How do I look?
You look really cool, Deb.
All right. Here I go.
Don't take too long.
I won't. Do not move. Okay?
I don't like to go outside. you doing?
All right.
Good. Hey, who's that girl? Is she your friend?
Yeah, my best friend. She's waiting for her boyfriend. Ah, it's beat here. I hate when it's beat.
Well, you could play pool.
Yeah?
Hey, Bill. She wants to play pool.
Put her name down?
Give me a break.
Give her a break. She wants to play real bad. Silly.
I don't want to play pool anyway.
I don't mean either. I just like to watch until I get bored.
Yeah? Me too. I'm exactly like that.
Right. Your best friend is waving at you.
Oh, no. I know. It's no big deal. I'll be right back. What the fuck are you doing?
I'm bored, Deb.
Beth, I might go home with him.
Oh, no, Deb.
But why not? What's wrong?
I don't know. Are you sure he's really into you?
You are acting like you're jealous or something.
I am not. Fuck you.
No, fuck you. I mean, I want to be with this guy, and I don't think you should be ruining it on me.
What am I supposed to do all night?
Just take my car and just go anywhere you want.
Alone?
Yes. Now smile and act like you're having a good time, okay? I don't want him to think we're arguing over this, all right? Okay, fine. Have a good time, Deb. Thanks. Hey.
That looks serious.
No.
She looks a little bored.
No, she just... I mean, she just loves waiting for him. You want to go someplace?
What, you mean now?
Yeah, why not? It's pretty beat here.
Come here. Where do you want to go?
Anywhere. How about your house?
All right.
All right.
Mrs. Miller, this is Amber Orlam Tuchinski. I was wondering if you wanted to watch TV with me.
He just left, that's all. Just without warning. He had a girlfriend, of course. He actually brought her into my living room and said she was an old school friend he just ran into. And, she had dinner with us. Sat down to dinner, just Ralph, Debbie, me, and her. Debbie was only 13. Then next day, he just threw some things in the car and drove off.
Good riddance. What do people call you? They call you Ginny?
Sometimes.
I'd be honored if I could call you Ginny.
Yes, sure.
Or Jin?
Jin?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, after I met you, I thought about you a lot. And that's what I called you in my mind. Jin.
I like it. Can I call you Nikki? That be okay?
Sure, that's fine.
Okay. Nikki.
This is a really nice house.
Thanks.
Did your mother help you fix it up?
I'm gonna have a beer. You want one?
Yeah. Thanks. This is a really nice house.
Thanks.
I live with my mother. There's two bedrooms, but I moved in the basement, and now I have my privacy.
That's good.
I give an incredible blowjob.
Oh, yeah?
You'll never get better.
Really? I'd like to see that.
Well, maybe you will.
Come here.
You leaving?
I was thirsty.
That's last night's beer. Must be pretty rank.
I didn't have that much of it. Hey, Rick.
Yeah?
We should get in the bed.
It's good here.
On the floor? It's not that comfortable.
I'm fine. I'm good.
Why don't you want to get in your bed with me?
All right. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
I'm real tired.
Yeah, me too. How long have you lived here?
10 months.
Oh, it's beautiful. Really gorgeous.
Thanks.
Are you doing stuff to it? Painting and stuff?
Yeah. I'm doing all kinds of things. Especially the outside.
Like what?
Well, I gotta recalk the windows.
That's important.
Yeah, and I want to build a deck off the back.
Really? You're going to do all that yourself?
Yeah.
That's great.
I definitely want to put in French doors instead of those sliding things.
Oh, that would look so good.
Yeah, you think so?
Definitely.
Yeah, okay, good. You know, I wasn't so sure.
Oh, no. This place is going to look amazing.
Yeah. All right. I got a lot of ideas. I'll show you what I mean sometime.
Cool.
Sweet dreams.
Sweet dreams.
You want to sit?
Not yet.
Okay.
I was thinking...
You have to go?
No, I was thinking that maybe we could go into your living room, have our coffee there.
Sure. Sure. Okay, yeah, that'd be nice.
You know, this is the first time I've really been in your living room.
Oh, I never come in here. I just come in to watch TV sometimes.
My wife and I drank our coffee in the living room all the time. It was nice with the sun coming through.
This room is drab, isn't it? I'm going to fix it up, though.
Oh, it's very nice.
It was always my dream to have really beautiful furniture in here. I started saving for it. I don't know why, because I don't see me going and spending all the money I have, you know, just on me.
Well, there you're wrong. You should. Yeah, money should be for that.
I've been saving so long, I don't think I could just spend it on my living room. I sound like a millionaire, don't I? Well, you know, when I went to work at Skyways about 11 years ago, I decided I would just take one day's tips out of every week, every month, the whole year, and then I'd save it in a passbook savings account.
Well, that's smart.
First year I couldn't save it, though, because Debbie really needed a new coat. And she was 15. She wanted this little jacket, little white fur on it, a big zipper and a buckle. I said, Debbie, you can't have that for winter. You gotta have a long coat, keep your little butt warm. Well, we could not get together on that. You know what I did? I took out my passbook. I bought two coats, a long one and a short one. She was so proud. God.
That's good. I mean, you did something to make life a little nicer.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm starving. Are you?
Not really.
What do you have in the refrigerator?
I don't know.
Oh, just like a guy. I make incredible eggs and hash browns.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm a really good cook. You want to set the table while I start breakfast?
No, I got to get to my sister's. I'm helping my brother-in-law work on his boat today.
Oh, really? I love boats. Is it down at the marina? Because I always go sit out there in the dock. I might have seen it.
It's in his driveway.
Oh, are you going to put it in the water sometime?
Yeah, that's what it's for. You're funny.
Thanks. Hey, Rick.
I got a lot of stuff to do today, too. But I still have time for breakfast, you know?
Actually, I'm not really a breakfast-eating kind of guy.
Okay?
Okay. No big deal.
Hey, I'll take a rain check.
Okay, it'll be a rain check then. Hey, how about I make you dinner one night this week?
Okay, sounds good.
Wednesday, my house?
Sure.
Great.
Write down your address.
Okay.
I got a pen.
Thanks. It's 197 DeWitt Ave. 8 o'clock. Wednesday. Filet mignon.
Okay.
I'd be careful, Dab. I don't know why you want to cook for him.
This is different, Beth. I didn't just go out and fuck some guy. I slept with him.
Like that to me, all right? So she starts shaking.
Oh.
Hey, Dad, how's the hysterical blindness?
It got a lot better. I met this guy at Ollie's.
Oh, Ollie's, I am so glad I met Stephen and I don't have to sit in that shithole with you anymore.
Yeah, me too. Wait, when did you meet this guy? On Friday night. He comes up and starts talking.
I went to the emergency room with you Friday.
Yeah. It was after that.
Well, you sure recovered fast.
Hey, the doctor told me to go out and have a good time. He did. That's what he said to do.
Well, it looks like that's just what you did.
This is not just some guy I met at Ollie's. I'm done with that. This is different. We were just laying in his bed and talking.
Talking?
Yeah, about fixing up his house.
You met a guy with a house.
Well, that's nice.
Well, I hope this one calls you.
He will.
Hi, Mel.
Morning, Annie.
Good morning.
Your guy is here, Virginia. Go talk to him.
Something wrong?
I got the horses right here.
What are you doing, handicapping?
No, it's I want to show you a brochure.
What?
It's for a mobile home park in Florida. Nice, huh?
Yeah.
Things are easy down there.
It's nice.
Think so?
Yeah, I guess so. You know, I don't know so much about Florida. I'm always so busy here. I just don't have time for daydreaming.
We could have a grand old time down there.
We?
So great. And you didn't even drop it once.
Are you watching?
Yeah. What's wrong?
Can we go to Ollie's now?
No, I can't, Dub. You know that. Remember when we used to sit out here and every guy who went by would beep at us? We were so hot.
Yeah. We were.
Rick drives a Ford Bronco.
Oh, really?
ML5180. You memorized his license plate?
Yeah.
So?
And this guy could be it, Beth. I can feel it. I could end up getting married or something.
There's no reason why I couldn't. I never had a kid or anything.
Fuck you, Deb. I could get married if I wanted to. Amber's a great kid.
I'm just saying, I didn't drop out of high school, okay?
Jeez,
good for you.
Woo! Hey, baby. Nice hat.
Mom.
What?
What? You're not 16 anymore.
So I'm just trying to have some fun.
Sitting out here ain't fun. It's like going backwards.
Yes, I'll tell her. Thank you.
Here you go.
What are you looking at?
JCPenney's catalog.
Engagement rings.
Look, so? A lot of people look at JCPenney's catalog. It's no big deal.
Yeah, but I've never seen you look at engagement rings before.
Why'd you circle that great big one?
Because it has class.
David and I got engaged, you know. That's different.
Oh.
Why? He gave me a ring. He came into the Pants Palace with it when I was working. I had this really long line and he waited on it. And then when it was his turn, he handed me this ring. It was just this little gold heart with a tiny diamond chip in it. And then he goes, I'm hungry. I gotta go to Sbarro's. My mother made me give it back, of course. Because that would have been stupid, right, Deb? I mean, to get married at 16?
Definitely.
He really wanted to, though. He wanted for us to get married, to have Amber Autumn together. Maybe it wouldn't have been so bad. I mean, he had just gotten that brand new Trans Am and everything, you remember? Who cares, Beth? I mean, it was a long time ago. Yeah, I know.
I don't know why you're always talking about the past.
I don't know. What's that for?
I owe you a hairspray.
Oh, thanks, Deb.
Do it myself.
Okay.
Stay out as late as you can tonight, Mom, okay?
Absolutely.
Amber. Amber. Yeah, tell your mother to come over. I'm cooking and it's very important. Yeah, just her. Yes, it's the filet mignon. Tell her to hurry, okay?
Just impossible. If I had you, could I ever want for more? It's just impossible.
Put a deposit on a mobile home. It has a lemon tree right up front.
I never saw a lemon tree.
Oh, now you're gonna have one.
I've never even been flowered.
Well, we used to go down there a lot, you know, with the kids on vacation.
We went to the Amish country once.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That must have been a lot of fun.
Yeah.
The horse and buggies and those funny clothes they wear.
Yeah, they got their own traditions.
I know.
Can the ocean keep from rushing to the shore? It's just impossible. If I had you, could I ever want for more? It's just impossible.
What town is it in? I'm gonna look it up. They got a great big map in the kitchen at Skyway's, got the whole country on it.
Jacksonville.
Yeah. I'm gonna look up Jacksonville for it.
I would sell my very soul and not regret it. For to live without your love is just impossible, impossible.
Okay.
Ooh. Did you get to see Rick?
No.
He wasn't there yet.
Did she make the filet mignon?
She's making it right now.
How'd it go?
He didn't show up.
Is the fun over?
Oh, Nikki.
Well, I'll eat it.
Go to hell!
Kibby.
Thank you.
Mr. Murphy? It's Debbie Miller. I can't come in today. I'm really sick. Can you tell the girls I'm really sick? Yes, I have a temperature. 100.4, I think. Thank you. I will.
Hey, no work today?
No.
Surprised to see you here.
Yeah, I'm surprised too. It's no big deal. I gotta go.
Oh, would you like a ginger ale or something?
No, thanks. I just came for my cigarettes.
Stay a while, huh? Sit down. Come on. One ginger ale, please.
You got it.
So. How's it going?
All right.
How's your job at the warehouse?
Good.
Well, that's a good job, you know. If you work hard enough, you'll be running that place in no time.
It's not like that.
I sold auto parts. 37 years.
I know.
I miss it sometimes.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
I come in here at night with my friend Beth.
Oh, yeah, I bet you have a good time. You don't think I understand, do you? You know, I understand. And you should go out and have good times. It's important. It's all part of your life.
I know. But...
But what?
Nothing.
I know what you're thinking, you know. I think it myself sometimes. This must be the end of the world. But it never is, you know. And you'll find that out.
I know.
A girl like you has to be careful.
What's that mean?
You got that special something, like your mother. And not many people are gonna see that.
See what?
That you're real smart. Well, I bet a lot of people tell you that.
Yeah.
Good. Finish your ginger ale.
All right.
just got caught up in what he was doing, that's all.
Do you even know what he was doing?
I'm sure he'll explain.
He didn't show up, Ma. He knew you'd be standing there on the curb waiting, and he didn't show up.
I'm sure he'll...
He'll what? He's not coming back, Ma. God, didn't you learn how to tell when a guy ain't coming back?
Oh, yes. Yeah, I did.
He's just like I thought all along.
Like Debbie, you're being so unfair.
He's blowing you off, Ma.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, I do. Believe me. I can't believe he almost had me fooled for a second.
He's not fooling anybody.
How do you really know?
Because he loves me.
God! This is so stupid!
It's not stupid.
I can't fucking talk to you!
Well, I can't talk to you either, so just shut up.
Waiting around for this guy.
Yeah, I know.
My father was supposed to take me to Six Flags last summer, and he didn't show up.
It was rainy, Amber, you remember?
My mother told me that when your father left, you packed a suitcase and kept it by your bedroom door because he said he was coming back to get you, and you didn't unpack it for over a month.
God, did you tell her everything, Beth? Sorry.
Maybe it's time to expand your horizon.
I'll get it, Ma.
Hello? Yeah? Yeah, hold on, please. Nick's son, Ma.
Oh. Hello, Michael. I've heard many nice things about you. So sorry for your terrible loss, Michael. Oh, yes? Oh, what? I'll see you then. Heart attack.
Can I help you look for something, Ma?
Oh, we're out of almost everything. I haven't been keeping up with anything lately.
Do you want me to help you?
Oh, no.
Honey, I just have to start making this list, you know.
You're good, honey. I'm fine.
I just gotta do this.
Okay.
Thank you so much for coming. Oh. Virginia. Hi. I'm Michael.
Michael.
I just wanted to tell you that you meant a lot to my father. He talked about you every day, you know. I'm glad that we got a chance to see my father happy again.
I'm so sorry, Deb.
Deb, are you okay?
I guess so.
It's such a difficult time.
Very difficult.
Yeah. Deb, I gotta ask. Is Rick being there for you and your mother?
Of course he is.
With Bobby. He's a really good friend of ours.
Yeah, mine too. He's so sweet to me. Remind me to introduce you to my fiance.
I've met him.
Oh, yeah?
A few times.
Oh. Hey, well, I hope that you meet somebody special soon. I gotta go.
Having fun, Zeb?
What?
I gave Bobby my phone number.
Ollie's. Hey, Beth. Phone.
For me?
Shit. Wait, what time is it? Look, I don't know.
Hello? Amber, calm down. I was just about to come home. Look, Amber, you can't just call me. Okay, I heard you. Okay, I'll come home real soon.
In an hour.
No, real soon, honey. Don't you dare. Do not call me. Amber. Amber.
Shit. Did she hang up on you?
Yes. She says she's calling my parents in Florida if I don't come right home.
Well, your parents can't do nothing to you.
Deb, my mother's gonna kill me. She's gonna get all started again, saying, Amber, Autumn, you wanna come stay with your grandma?
Yeah, Beth, so what?
So? Debbie.
You're exaggerating. You're overreacting, okay? Just sit down.
No, I'm
look.
Not.
Have a drink.
Thanks.
I was running out of here so early. But now you should stay all night.
Really? You want me to?
After everybody goes home, we could talk.
You could, Beth.
No, but I can't. I could still hang out, though. At my house. I mean, you could come over to my house one night if you want.
Pretty much all I do is get up, go to the gym, come here. I'm the type of guy who doesn't need rules. Has to be this way at this time. Past that.
Oh, okay, fine.
Ollie's.
Let me friggin' talk to her, okay?
Dad,
no.
Don't.
No. Amber, look, your mother and I are grown-ups, and we're out having a... Oh, hi, Miss Tushinsky.
Yeah.
That's right here.
Hi, Ma. I was on my way home. Listen, Amber's exaggerating the whole thing. I have not been in a bar every night of the week. Okay, I am. I am a good mother. Okay. Okay, I'm coming right now. Okay. Bobby. Let's just go. All right.
You really going?
Don't worry about it.
Maybe I can swing by when I get off. Got a porch light or something you can leave on for me?
Yeah, okay.
Can't believe she's doing this to us.
Well, she's right, Deb. I can't go leaving her alone anymore.
What?
It's no big deal. It's just Ollie's. It's not like it's gonna change my life. Come on, Amber's waiting.
I'm not going.
What? Why?
Maybe I want another drink. Here, just take my car.
I gotta go, Deb.
Fine. Bye.
Bye.
screwdriving.
You got it.
See you later.
Hold on. You okay?
I'm fine. Why?
No reason.
Good. Do you ever work here in the afternoon?
Once or twice.
So different. All men sitting around drinking.
How'd you know?
My father used to come here.
Oh, yeah? You came here with him?
I came in looking for him. But he must have changed everything in his life because I never saw him.
Shame, Dad.
Another screwdriver. This song is so great.
For you.
Well, thanks.
What are you doing?
I'm out having a good time.
Are you alone?
No, of course not. Where you been?
Around, you know.
No.
Well, look, I gotta go hang out with my buddies over there, so...
Oh, hey, hey, have a drink with me first. Come on, I'll buy it.
Oh, no. No, they're waiting for me, so I gotta go.
All right, well, I'll be right here, okay?
Okay. Hey. What are you doing after?
I don't know. Anything?
You want to get laid?
Okay, I'm up for it.
Okay. Good. Oh. I'll be back when I'm ready to go. Okay?
All right, cool.
Yo, Dad. Seen you talking to him.
Yeah, I know.
Looking good.
Yeah, it is good. Something special.
Okay.
I just really feel like dancing again.
Too bad there's no dance floor there.
I don't need one. Do you? Dance with me.
I don't really want to. I don't want
to. Why don't you want to dance with me?
What? I don't know.
Down and talk for a minute.
Why?
Why not? I mean, why don't you want to sit down and talk to me?
I'm not looking for someone to talk to.
Oh, thanks. That is nice. Thanks a lot. That is real nice of you. Great. Just walk away from me. Hey, Frank. What? I mean, you don't know me? I'm going home with you tonight and you don't know me?
Calm down.
Understand. I've been thinking about you. Me and you could really hang out together.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, just sit down with me.
You okay, buddy?
Yeah. I'm going home.
You what? Quick. Just talk to me. Just talk to me.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Hey, Rick. Just want to make you feel filet mignon.
You should sober up.
Maybe you don't see things so clearly.
Hey, fuck you!
Thank you.
Oh, my God. Mom! What the fuck?
Deborah, where'd all this come from?
Value City.
Oh, my God. Where'd we get the money?
I saved up.
What? You mean this is really ours?
Yeah, I guess.
I can't believe this, Ma. This is amazing. Oh, my God. Sit down already.
Doesn't feel like one.
That's okay. We'll get used to it being so nice.
Yeah. Sure.
I'm quitting smoking.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
You know, if you wanted to, Deb, we could start having parties out here like we used to in high school. We could play Neil Young and Bruce. All the people would stop by. We would have to get beer.
Yeah. And we'd have to get lawn chairs. I mean, we can't just be sitting out here on the steps like a couple of kids.
Oh, definitely. I like that idea.
Yeah, me too. Hey, Ma.
Hi, honey.
Oh, God. Look. What's she?
Hey, Amber.
What?
You gonna do your new routine?
You want me to?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll watch this time. Promise.
Great.